in a classroom where book bags and desks.
It becomes a lot of practice.
Take a back seat to students with their newfound hobby.
I started about October of last year.
Just last year?
Yeah.
Minds are mulling.
It's not easy at first.
Just as quickly as hands are catching.
Various difficulties for everyone. It took me a while to do it, but I've seen people who can pick it up within the hour or two.
Or not catching.
Too often. But that's okay. You know, dropping is part of juggling.
One of the newest classes offered at Iowa State.
This is the mathematics of juggling. And the goal in juggling is about controlling patterns.
Assistant mathematics professor Steve Butler says, to start juggling, get comfortable throwing one ball back and forth from your right hand to your left. After that, add in a second ball.
This is the hard part. Once you master this, then you're good to go. And it's the following. I want to throw this ball. I want to catch it over here, but this hand is occupied. So I need to release this ball and get it over to there. Now the natural instinct is to be like panic. And just do a quick like, oh no, it's gonna win. No panic, do not panic. What you wanna do is throw this ball, and as it's coming up, and it's starting to come back down, you say, okay, now's the time to throw this one. So throw, that's it.
And once you've accomplished that, it's time to think about patterns.
And that comes down to how you throw a ball. So we wanna describe different types of throws. So we describe them by the length of time until you catch. So this is a one, because you catch it right away, and then a two, is a little bit longer, and usually odd throws will go across, even to the same hand. One, and then you have two, then you have three, and four, and you have five.
For example. Now,
this mathematically is what we call 4-0, because your right hand is throwing four, and your left hand is throwing zero. I can even sort of do a click. There are lots of patterns. There are infinitely many.
And that's where the math comes in.
Juggling. And the mathematics, it's a way to open up your eyes to see more possibilities there are. It's a way to explore patterns. Mathematics is the science of patterns. Juggling is the science of controlling patterns. I mean, people have been juggling for thousands of years, but it wasn't until they came around and said, okay, let's analyze the situation mathematically. What's possible? Say you're juggling in this type of pattern, and you want to transition to something else. How can you do that? How many different ways? What makes it look nice? And there's all sorts of questions you can ask.
That's why Butler believes.
You don't have to be a great mathematician or a great juggler. You just have to be willing to be interested in both.
And his students are. And they've already accomplished his main goal for the class, knowing how to simply juggle.
No one will believe them. I mean, you took a class in juggling? Prove it. I do want to have them experience with seeing the mathematical ideas like proofs. How do you prove something?
And that's when.
I'd like students to say, hey, this math stuff, you can do some interesting things with it. You can relate something that students can see, like, yes, I can see an application of mathematics. I can see the ideas.
Proving that math can be fun.
I can go to someone and I can say, math, it's cool. They're like, math, no, I hate calculus. No, it's not just calculus. There's other stuff, like here, juggling. Math is totally awesome and useful for everybody.
Alex Murphy.
Math isn't meant to be easy. I mean, if it was too easy, it wouldn't be any fun.
Iowa State University News Service.